lot of anniversaries this week. The first anniversary, actually, that actually took place before the 311 anniversary was the 310 anniversary that people don't really think about, which is the, in fact, was it March 8? Pardon me. Was it March 8? Well, this is exactly the thing. It hasn't really been marked until very recently. It was the Tokyo firebombing, the firebombing of Tokyo by U.S. bombers in 1945, that took place on March 8th. It actually was as destructive, in fact, in terms of loss of life, more destructive than the A-bombings. In a single night, incendiaries were dropped on Tokyo, particularly around the palace and Shitamachi areas, which were particularly all built out of wood, and all the houses were close together, and something like 100,000 people died in a single day just from a purposely generated firestorm. I've covered this in more detail, I think, on the anniversary last year. It's not marked or remembered like the A-bombings. I mean, partly because the A-bombings themselves were just remarkable and they marked a milestone in history. But it says something about the scale of this bombing, that it actually inflicted in some ways more damage than either of the A-bombings on Tokyo. It wasn't really marked. I mean, partly the commemoration and the peace park and so on in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. They are people. Americans often misinterpret these as kind of victim self pity memorials to and things to make Americans feel guilty about. A lot of Americans preemptively take them as like an attack on America or Americans. And I always point out, no, if it's a screw you to anybody, it's a screw you to Tokyo, all of these regions. Tokyo, Japan, like for hundreds of years, has been extremely decentralized. And it was one of the things about the Meiji period and the increasing fascism of Japan that Japan became very centralized around Tokyo. And there was a lot of resentment at that, by these cities. And not only was there this huge centralization, but they were suddenly getting bombed because of the decisions of Tokyo. Their kids were being dragged away to war because of the decisions of Tokyo. So yeah, there was a lot of resentment of that, and it was partly because of that that they built up these huge memorials emphasizing that they will never allow themselves to be dragged into war again. This is why during after the Kobe earthquake they couldn't call themselves defense forces into Kobe. And at the same time, it's also why the Tokyo event wasn't marked. It's funny, this took place in March. It took place 5 or 6 months before the end of the war. And even though it was as destructive as Hiroshima or Nagasaki, it didn't have an impact. Obviously, the war carried on for months, even though this is where the seat of government was. This is where most of the center of government was burned down. And it was taken after the war that were people who marked it. It was almost like a revisionist, kind of a thing. And it was sort of taken as improper. It's only been very recently that it's actually even been okay for people in Tokyo to mark the fact that 100,000, mostly civilians, died. And it's not that long ago. It's recently enough that there are people alive who experienced it. Of course, there are people alive who experienced the horrors that Japan inflicted in China and in Korea and, in mainland Asia and so on as well. So, Japan doesn't have a monopoly on anything. And it's kind of funny, in the West, there's a tendency to say, well, Japan brought it upon itself. But in the end of the day, if you're like a three-year-old kid, who's lost your family or been orphaned or has the whole, has your whole neighborhood burned down, you didn't bring that on yourself. The government of Japan, waged a war of aggression. But in the end of the day, that really marked a point during the war that, it's crazy that somehow, somewhere along the line, it became okay to slaughter 100,000 people in a pretty horrible way, as part of a war strategy. And that's what happened in Tokyo. And look, Tokyo hasn't complained about it. Frankly, they've waited till most of the people have gone to even mark the day. But it was remarkable, and it's remarkable it happened right where I am. Hard to imagine, actually. But that was a thing. And I think another big part of the reason that it was looked over was partly because of the topic I'm about to talk about in a moment, which was the fact that Japan is so accustomed to having these sort of mega disasters that it's behind a lot of the culture that we see, the whole Godzilla thing, the whole destructive force of nature type villains and so on that you have. It's a big part of the mindset and culture of Japan that this is kind of looked at in natural disaster terms. But it's certainly a remarkable thing, and it's worth remembering that just because you're not held to account for it doesn't mean that you can't be thoughtful about we shouldn't do this sort of thing. You know, the idea that it was, that it's necessary, if we accept that it was necessary to firebomb, you know, a densely populated city with the explicit purpose of trying to kill a lot of people, if we accept that that was okay, it could happen again, and it could happen to us. You know, I mean, imagine if someone did to New York what was done to Tokyo, you know, a densely populated city. I don't think people would accept there's any circumstance in which that would be justified. And, you know, I don't think it's not a call to beat ourselves up. It's a call to reflect and accept that, you know, we should not allow ourselves to do that again. So anyway, that's certainly a not very widely marked anniversary, but one worth noting.